looked out for me, Jehovah Jireh. He is my God. All of the earth is his, in the fullness thereof. He's everything I need. You can be sure of Jehovah Jireh. Shall supply my need. He is my El Shaddai. Jehovah Jireh. Yes! Oh, yes!
Say, my God!
My God is more than enough. He shall supply all my needs.
Yeah. My El Shaddai.
Yeah.
He looks out for me.
Oh, Jehovah Jireh. Yes, my God. Oh, sing it now. My God is more than enough.
Yeah.
Enough. How many knows he's more than enough tonight? One more time.
My God is more than enough. He shuts the floor on my knees. He is my El Shaddai. He looks out for me. Jehovah Jireh. He is my God. So why should I worry
about the highs and the lows?
Yeah, the ups and the downs and my faith I should know.
Tonight. Thank God for all of his goodness and his mercies. Come on, just welcome the Spirit of God to continue to minister to the hearts of the people that's been prayed for already, that God will do exceedingly abundantly tonight. Hallelujah. Come on, just welcome the presence of the sweet Spirit of God. God would touch and save and heal, deliver tonight. The power of God in the name of Jesus. Come on. Thank you for it tonight, Jesus. Thank you for the awesome service this morning. I praise you for tonight.
The Word is the beginning.
God, we honor you for it.
One with God.
Thank you,
the Lord Most High.
Come on, just raise your hands and love him tonight.
Your hidden glory is creation.
Yes, he is.
Now revealed in Jesus Christ. What a beautiful name. Your love is greater. And what could separate us now? What a wonderful name it is. What a wonderful name it is. The name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a wonderful name it is. And nothing compares to this. What a wonderful name it is. Jesus. didn't want him without us. So Jesus, you brought heaven down. You see,
come on, worship
my
tonight.
Sins were great, but yes. Your love was greater.
Oh, yes, it was.
And what could separate us now?
Oh, yes.
And what a wonderful name it is.
Come on, lift your voice.
Oh, what a wonderful name it is. The name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a wonderful name it is, and nothing compares to this. And what a wonderful name it is,
that day,
that day. What a powerful name it is, the name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a powerful name it is, and nothing can stand again. What a powerful name it is, the name of Jesus. You are raised through life again. But you see, you have no rival, and you have no equal. And now and forever, our God reigns. Lord, yours is the kingdom, and yours is the glory, and yours is the name above all names. What a powerful name. Oh, just raise your hands and worship him tonight. Worship him tonight because he's a powerful name. That name of Jesus. That name above all names tonight. He's above all names tonight. That name of Jesus. Jesus tonight. Hallelujah. Oh, what a powerful name it is. What a powerful name it is. The name of Jesus. Christ my King. What a powerful name it is, and nothing can stand again. What a powerful name it is, the name. Oh, just let him fill you tonight with that peace tonight. Let him fill you with that peace tonight. What a powerful name, that name of Jesus that calms all fear.
that name of Jesus. That name of Jesus that can heal, that can save tonight. What a powerful name. Powerful name, that name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Just worship Him tonight. Just raise your hands and worship Him tonight. Enter into His presence tonight. Hallelujah. What a powerful name it is. The name of Jesus Christ, my King. Oh, what a powerful name it is. And nothing can stand against. What a powerful name it is. The name of Jesus. And what a wonderful name it is. What a wonderful name it is. The name of Jesus Christ, my King. And what a wonderful name it is. And nothing can stand against. What a wonderful name it is. The name of Jesus.
Hallelujah. Let's give Jesus a hand clap of praise. Hallelujah. A wonderful name tonight.
No name like it.
There's no name given unto man that we could be saved other than the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. How many is thankful for that name tonight? Hallelujah. You can be seated just for a moment. I tell you what, the Bible says He's no respecter of persons. So, you know, you may have messed up or you may have a lot of things in your past, but Jesus is willing to forgive them all. He's willing to set you up on a solid rock, establish your goings, and give you a bright future. That's our King tonight, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Tonight we'll get ready and take up tonight's offering. The offering takers will make their way to the front tonight. The little kids can come up front and sing tonight. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Brother Richard, stand and testify tonight. Hallelujah. Sister Minnie, stand and testify tonight.
sheep, blah, blah, blah. I pray the Lord my soul to keep. I just want to be a sheep, blah, blah, blah. I just want to be a sheep, blah, blah, blah. I just want to be a sheep, blah, blah, blah. I pray the Lord my soul to keep. I just want to be a sheep, blah, blah, blah. Don't want to be a goat,
no.
Don't want to be a goat,
no.
Have they got any hope,
no.
Don't want to be a goat,
no.
I just want to be a sheep, bah, bah, bah. I just want to be a sheep, bah, bah, bah. I pray the Lord my soul to keep. I just want to be a sheep, bah, bah, bah. Don't want to be a hypocrite. Don't want to be a hypocrite. Cause they're not hip to it. Don't want to be a hypocrite. I just want to be a sheep, bah, bah, bah. I just want to be a sheep, bah, bah, bah. I pray the Lord my soul to keep. I just want to be a sheep, bah, bah, bah. Don't want to be a Pharisee. Don't want to be a Pharisee. Cause they're not fair, you see. Don't want to be a Pharisee. I just want to be a sheep, bah, bah, bah. I just want to be a sheep, bah, bah, bah. I pray the Lord my soul to keep. I just want to be a sheep, bah, bah, bah. Don't want to be a Sadducee. Don't want to be a Sadducee. Cause they're so sad, you see. Don't want to be a Sadducee. I just want to be a child of God. I just want to be a child of God. Walking the same Matthew trod. I just want to be a child of God. I just want to be a sheep, ba ba ba. I just want to be a sheep, ba ba ba. I pray the Lord my soul to keep. I just want to be a sheep, ba ba ba.
Hallelujah. Let's give him a hand clap tonight. Hallelujah. How many wants to be a sheep tonight? Hallelujah. Let's give Sister Sheila a hand as she comes and sings tonight. Give her a hand clap. Hallelujah. While she's making her way to the front, Brother Jason Popplewell, stand and testify tonight. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Brother Brian, stand and testify tonight.
Just like to thank God because he is a right on time God.
Yeah.
And if we just hold on, like Sister Minnie was saying, and he's going to do great and wonderful things because he is an awesome, awesome God.
They
stand
for Jesus.
they were so hard and dry, till it seemed all hope was gone and I would die. Well, then I wondered, where was he? Was he still
give the Lord a hand clap of praise tonight. Hallelujah. He's right on time. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's give Sister Jean a hand as she sings, testifies. Give her a hand clap.
This is my testimony tonight. Too many miles behind me, as Sister Minnie said. No time to quit. It's a time to press on.
Yes.
Time to look forward. We got a prize awaiting us.
Yes.
Too many miles there behind me. There's too many trials. Searching the right road to choose. Oh, but somewhere up ahead, there's blue, clear water. And if it's just one word, I refuse to use.
Amen. Let me believe that.
There's too many rivers that my feet have walked through. Too many treasures, they're waiting over yonder. I've got too much to gain, to lose. and too many miles there behind me. There's too many trials hard through, and too many tears they help me to remember that I've got too much to gain. There's too many rivers that my feet have walked through. Too many treasures, they're waiting over yonder. And there's so much that I've got to gain to lose. Now I've crossed that hot burn. I was searching the right road to choose.
Come on now.
Oh, but somewhere up ahead, there is cool, clear water, and defeat is just one word I refuse to use.
Somebody praise him now.
And there's too many rivers that my feet have walked through. Too many treasures, they're waiting over yonder. There's too much to gain to lose.
Oh, yes. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's great to be in the house of the Lord tonight. He's a great God and greatly to be praised. Yeah. So let's stand to our feet one more time and let's give Jesus a hand clap of praise. Let's make him welcome in our midst. Hallelujah. Solid Rock is all about Jesus. How many's excited and looking forward to the Word of God tonight? Hallelujah. Help me make welcome our pastor, the man of God, Pastor Wayne Keith. Give him a hand clap.
Shout of praise. Hallelujah. Come on. Amen. Turn around and shake your neighbor's hand tonight. Amen. Tell somebody, amen, God's a good God tonight. Go across the aisle, shake your neighbor's hand. Tell somebody.
Well, if I'm worried about tomorrow, oh, when I reach my journey's end, well, satisfied with my Jesus. Satisfied, oh, satisfied,
satisfied.
Oh, no trouble will ever get me down. Oh, when my eyes are closed, my cheeks are be a rest, then you'll know. Got that old time religion. That is why I'm satisfied. Oh, well, my friends, they all forsake me and they turn me from their door. Oh, if they sow those seeds of kindness, oh, make the thorns and they grow. Well, it won't matter. Oh, over yonder. Oh, when I reach that
side. Well, I'm going to sit down, oh, with my Jesus, oh, satisfied. I'm satisfied.
Satisfied,
oh, satisfied.
Satisfied.
Oh, satisfied.
Satisfied.
Oh, no trouble can ever get me down. When my eyes are closed in death, with my Jesus I'll be at rest. Then you'll know I'm satisfied. Well, if my friends, they all forsake me,
oh, yes,
and they turn me from their door, oh, if they sow those seeds of kindness, oh, make the thorns that grow.
Come on, put your hands on the
well,
same
it
with
won't matter,
matter
over yonder, oh, when I reach that other side, but I'm going to sit down, oh, with my Jesus, so satisfied.
Satisfied.
Oh, satisfied.
Satisfied.
Oh, satisfied.
Satisfied.
No trouble can ever get me down. When my eyes are closed and deaf, with my cheeks on the arrest, oh, then you'll know I'm satisfied. I've got that old-time religion. I got that old-time religion. Satisfied. Satisfied. Well, satisfied.
Satisfied.
Well, satisfied.
Satisfied.
Oh, no trouble can ever let you down. When my eyes are closed to death, with my cheeks on the arrest, oh, then you'll know I'm satisfied. Oh, then you'll know I'm satisfied.
We'll give the Lord a shout of praise tonight. Come on, church. Hallelujah. Come on, give him a praise tonight. Amen. Hallelujah. How many knows he's a mighty good God tonight? Awesome service this morning. One prayed and, amen, gave her heart to the Lord, and that's an awesome thing. Amen. Great service. Amen. Wonderful Spirit of God in the house this morning. And the message, amen, you know, you could take that message and preach a week off of it and realize that these strongholds Satan has used in are being defeated by the blood of Jesus. How many believes that tonight? Amen. He's a mighty good God. How many knows he's a mighty good God? You that have your Bibles, the book of Exodus tonight, chapter number 14. Exodus chapter 14. Remain standing if you would tonight. And I want to preach just a few minutes of what God shared with me. And amen, spoke to me about this service. And I do know that God has showed me things about Solid Rock and about revival and about the move of God. And if we'll allow God and we'll keep our hearts humble before God and continue to seek him, folks, God wants to do some great things. Some of you really need a deliverance in your minds because your mind is troubled. See, God called me is greater than the situation is. And there's people that don't want to believe that they even have needs. But each and every one of us has something we have to deal with. And if we don't deal with it, it gets stronger and stronger. Till after a while, it's a besetting sin. Amen. But tonight, God is good. And I want to preach tonight by the grace of God. What do you have? You know, so many times we feel inadequate, we feel insignificant, but we don't realize what we really have. Let me believe that. If you could go to some of these third world countries and see what they have and what you have, you are a millionaire. Many of you don't sleep in a little shack with a tin roof and on the floor. You don't cook outside on an open fire. And they say that if most of us, if we got change in our pockets, we're wealthier. We're more wealthy than a third part of the world is, just with change in your pocket. We're blessed of the Lord, really are. Now, we all got discomforts and we all got our likes and dislikes, but I'm blessed of the Lord. I'm blessed by the power of God. I'm blessed and I'm going forward tonight. Somebody shout amen. I want everybody to go, but if you don't go, I'm going to get in the ark anyhow. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Your mind better be made up. I'm going all the way. Amen. If children don't want to go, I'm going to go on. That don't mean it won't hurt me, but I'm got to go on. Got to make that decision. I'm going on with Jesus just the same. How many believes that tonight? Amen. If friends don't want to go, I got to go on. That ain't easy. I don't like to even say those things, but it's still the truth. Amen. If I don't go, if you got your mind made up, you're going on anyhow. Somebody shout amen. But in the book of Exodus chapter number 14, if you'll go to verse number 11 tonight, the children of Israel came out of Egypt. I'm not going to preach about that, but I want to use a text out of this. Children of Israel came out of Egypt. They had traveled a couple days' journey. They got out into the wilderness there, into the Red Sea. And they got there, and then they looked behind them, and they saw Pharaoh and his mighty army coming after them. And it was a terrible sight because they knew that Pharaoh wasn't coming out there just to have a talk to them. He was coming out there to slaughter them and to take what he could back to Egypt. Somebody shout amen. And the people got in a diversion. They got into a place, amen, that God had to do something. And I believe that we're in the hour that God's got to do something. Amen. Superstar preachers don't have it. Amen. Mega churches ain't what it's about. It's about somebody that still knows how to pray. Can I get a witness in this house? And many of us are right to a point in this dilemma in some way that we've got things facing us that's impossible, and the enemy behind us wants to take us back into some kind of a bondage. The Bible says in verse number 11, let's go to verse 10 if you would, Heather. Verse 10. Knows he's a mighty God. And when Pharaoh drew nigh, the children of Israel lifted up their eyes, and behold, the Egyptians marched after them. They were what? Many of you, amen, you know what it is to feel afraid. And the children of Israel cried out unto the Lord. They said unto Moses, because there was no graves in Egypt, has thy taken to die in this wilderness? Wherefore hast thou dealt with us to carry us forth out of Egypt? Is not this the word that we did tell thee, saying, let us alone, that we may serve the Egyptians? For it had been better for us to serve the Egyptians than we should die in this wilderness. And Moses said unto the people, stand, fear ye not, stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. Somebody shout hallelujah. Which he will show to you this day. For the Egyptians who you have seen today, you shall see them again no more. And the Lord shall fight for you, and you shall hold your peace. And the Lord said unto Moses, wherefore cry thou unto me? Moses was saying, God, what are we going to do? He said, speak unto the children of Israel that they go forward. But lift up thy rod and stretch it out, thy hand over the sea, and divide it, and the children of Israel shall go on dry ground through the midst of the sea. Brother Don, would you say the prayer? Yes, God. Yes, God. Father, thank you. Yes, God. Hallelujah. Would you lift your hands right now towards heaven? Come on, lift your hands towards heaven. I feel the Holy Ghost right now. Feel the power of God to touch somebody's heart right now. Thank you for it, Father. In the name of Jesus. God, there's a selling of the Holy Ghost in this house tonight. In the name of Jesus. Thank you for it tonight, God. God, I praise you for that mighty power tonight. Come on, just raise your hands and love him. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, just worship him for just a moment tonight. Come on, worship him. Come on, worship him. Hallelujah. I feel the Spirit of God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, my God and my King. Come on, worship him. God, I feel the Holy Ghost. Amen. I could preach for a moment, but I feel the Spirit of God right now just touching some lives again tonight by the power of God. Oh. Because I'm learning. I'm finding more power than I've ever dreamed. Because I've got a heart that's learning to lead. Hallelujah. God, I praise you for that visitation. Children, there's a visitation that's taking place in this place. Please don't miss it. Just open your heart to the things of God and let God touch you tonight. Let him minister to you in ways that only he knows how to do. In the name of Jesus. God, I thank you for your healing power tonight. I thank you for it tonight, Jesus. Come on, just love him. Come on, just love him for a moment tonight. Forget about your light bill. Forget about your water bill. Forget about work tomorrow for just a moment. And walk into the presence of God and let God touch you. In the name of Jesus. I was sad, brokenhearted, had an altar I nailed. Jesus, he came into my life that night. All things began to change. Hallelujah. And I began to become a real person by the blood of Jesus. Come on, would you love him? Because I've got a heart that's learning. Can you just sing it with me tonight? Learning to lean. I'm learning. I'm learning to lean. Hallelujah. I'm learning.
too late. Oh, Jesus.
I know he's a mighty God tonight. For just a moment, I feel like God prepared some of your hearts tonight for this. And I'd like to read verse number 16 again. God told Moses to stretch his rod, to lift up his rod. This rod had no magical powers in it. It was nothing but a stick. It was a shepherd's staff. It was a piece of wood. It was plain and simple. Can I get a witness in here? If you looked at it, you would say, well, what's he doing with that stick or that rod? But when he stretched it out over that sea, it began to divide. Can I get a witness? And I want to preach tonight when God said, amen, Moses, what's in your hand? What do you got? And I want to preach a few minutes tonight by the grace of God. Amen. Say it with me. What do I have? And I want to use what I have tonight to the glory of an almighty God. Now, somebody give God a shout of praise. Amen. You can be seated. Come on, give God a praise. When I begin to look at these scriptures and I begin to think about what God began to say to me, and God said, you know, sometimes we focus on our insufficiencies and we focus on things that, amen, that we don't have. But God's saying, why don't you look at what you do have? Tell your neighbor, I have it tonight by the glory of God. Can I get a witness in this house? To you, it may look like a stick. To you, it may look like a shepherd's rod. But in the hand of obedience, it becomes the instrument of an almighty God. Somebody ought to shout yes. You wonder why the devil fights you and tries to get you to become nothing. It's because in the hand of God, you are mighty. And the devil will be defeated in your life and somebody else's. How many believes that tonight? Turn around and tell your neighbor, I may look like an ordinary old stick. But when God gets a hold of me, something's going to happen. Woo! Can I get a witness in the house? Amen. I've seen it. Amen. I've seen one night a little lady about 85 pounds get anointed of the Holy Ghost. And I'm telling you, you would thought that she weighed 400 pounds. But when God gets a hold of you, it'll make a difference in you. Tell your neighbor, what do you have tonight? Come on, tell your neighbor, what do you have tonight? Amen. Get ready to use it. Tell your neighbor, get ready to use it by the power of an almighty God. I find in the book of Judges, chapter number 15 and 14, Samson had been bound. His hands was bound, and the brethren brought him to the Philistines to turn him over to the Philistines, and they shouted against Samson, and all of a sudden, the power of God came on him. The power of the Spirit of the Lord came mightily upon him. You ever get to praying, and the more you pray, oh, the more fervent it gets, the more passion it gets. And when you get done, you know heaven has invaded you. Woo! Samson was, his own brethren bound him. They said, you're causing us too much trouble. And we want to just give you to the Philistines that they won't bother us. They turned Samson over to the Philistines. They shouted against him. Tell your neighbor, I feel something moving. And the Spirit of God came on him, and those ropes or cords that was on his arms became his flax. It couldn't hold. It just burnt off like fire, and his bands was loosed off of his hands. Somebody ought to give God a shout of praise. I said, use what you got. And Samson looked out there at 1,000 warriors, Philistine men, and he saw a new jawbone. And he grabbed that new jawbone, and all of a sudden, the power of the Lord was upon him. It was a plain old donkey teeth, a jaw of a tooth, or jawbone of a donkey. But I'm telling you, in the hands of the anointed, it slew 1,000 men. Look at your neighbor's mom and say, quit that whimpering. Quit that belly aching. Quit. Amen. You see children get weaned of a bottle, they'll whimper and whine for it. Woo! They want that bottle back. God's looking for somebody. He said, I want to use you. I want to use you. I want to use you when you raise your hand. It'll be effective to somebody else. I want to use you when you walk around this front. It'll make an impact in somebody's life. I want to use you when you are praying, that you'll pray not my will, but thine, O God. Tell your neighbor, use what you got. Are you using what you got? Woo! Somebody shout amen. Amen. When they brought, what's your aunt's name? Carlina? Carletta. You know what I told God? Because I had the message. I said, God, I'm going to use my hands just like you told me to do. You said, lay hands on the sick. You said, lay hands on the sick, and they shall recover. Amen. I'm just going to do what God said do. Can I get a witness in here? Amen. It might just be a simple old stick. It may be nothing but a jawbone of a donkey. But when the power of God gets a hold of it, when the anointing of God gets a hold of it, amen, something's going to happen. When a church will allow God to use her in the way, I'm not ashamed. They can talk about me. They can ridicule me. And probably some do. They don't understand this. They call us fanatics, but somebody needs to get a hold of God. The devil is on a rampage tonight. Tell your neighbor, use what you got. Told y'all that story several years ago. Amen. Of a young man passing a little old church. Amen. The knees weren't even being met. Amen. He takes his own money, goes down to the hardware store. Working on a little old church building, patching the roof. Amen. Runs out of shingles, goes downtown. Amen. Gets shingles on the way to the building supply. Amen. A drunk driver hits him. He wakes up in the hospital. Amen. In serious condition with both legs amputated. Both of them. Just trying to serve God. Trying to fix a roof where people could serve God. I can't tell you all the things, but God says, are you willing to use what you got? Amen. The pastor's wife called another preacher friend. She said, you need to go talk to him. He's despondent. He's depressed. And my God, who wouldn't be with both legs amputated? One moment you walking down the, amen, off the ladder going to get shingles, and you wake up and you don't have a leg left. I'm going to tell you, that'd be shocking. That'd be enough to get upset. Even angry. Don't sit there and be holy now. Amen. That'd be difficult. Amen. And all of a sudden, amen, this happens, and The pastor's wife says, amen, he won't respond to us. He won't talk to us. He won't do anything. And she said, "If go and talk to him. See if you can get something to him to respond to you." He said, "I walked in that room. Amen, that old cloud of gloom and doom, amen, was in that place. And I can understand that. Amen, that old spirit of depression. Amen, but God said, amen, that preacher said, I talked to him. I tried to encourage him. I tried to quote scriptures. And nothing affected him. But he said, God, amen. I said, I'm getting ready to leave. Give me something. Help me. Somebody shout yes. Somebody ought to shout yes again. Hallelujah, by the power of God. He said, I turned to walk away. And I said, I guess the devil got what he wanted. You know, the devil will get what he wants if you're not willing to fight. He said, all of a sudden, heard his voice says, oh, he does he? That bar across the bed there that he could pull himself up by, he reached up and pulled himself up. He said, oh, let me tell you, I mean, I can kick the devil, but I'll bite him. He said, if I ain't got no teeth to bite him, I'll gum him. Tell you now, I'll gum him if I have to. Somebody shout hallelujah. God is good. Tell your neighbor, God's still good. Come on, tell your neighbor, God's still good. Amen, devil, if I gotta gum you, I'll bite you, I'll kick you, I'll poke you in the eye, but I refuse. God, here am I tonight, not saying it's easy, not going to tell you, amen, that I could do it, amen, but with the help of God, I still can. I still feel there's a jawbone, there's still a rod. Somebody ought to shout yes in here. Amen, raise your hand and say, amen, I still have something that I can use tonight. Listen to what 1 Kings chapter 17 verse number 8 says. Tell your neighbor, you ain't got no excuses tonight. Well, the Lord came unto Elijah. This was Elijah saying, arise and get to the Zarephath, which was Jezebel's hometown. Jezebel had been fighting to kill Elijah. God sent Elijah to her hometown, which belongeth to Zidon, and dwell there. And behold, I've commanded a widow woman to sustain thee. He arose and went to Zarephath, and when he came to the gate of the city, behold, the widow woman was there, gathering of sticks, and he called to her and said, fetch me, I pray thee, a little water in a vessel that I may drink. As she was going to fetch it, he called to her and said, bring me, I pray thee, a morsel of bread in your hand. Bring me a little piece of that cornbread. That's the best language I can give to y'all. How many of y'all ever cooked a pone of bread? Cook a pone of bread. Now, these young people probably don't know what a pone is. But anyhow, hallelujah. And she said, as the Lord thy God liveth, I don't have a cake. I ain't got one. All I've got is a little handful of meal in a barrel and a little oil in a cruse. And behold, I'm gathering two sticks that I may go in and dress it for me and my son. And we're going to eat this little bite of bread and then we're going to die of starvation. Tell your neighbor, use what you got. Now, if that had been people, now I'm going to tell you, I want to ask you this question. I want to ask me this question. If that had been me with one little bit of bread and just my little kid, my little son, I said, preacher, go get something for young. You got two good feet to go get it. Preach over here a minute. I'm not going to give you my last little bit of bread. My kid needs it more than you do. You got enough fat wrinkles, you'll live for a week. Come on. You thought it was easy for that lady to give up that little bit of bread? At least let me die with a little bit of food in my stomach. I just said, don't fear this. I can imagine me calling somebody and say, Lord told me to tell you give me your paycheck this week. Why, you'd laugh me all the way to town cashing it. Well, I need to preach over here again. Well, let me pray about that. Well, it'll take 6 months for you to pray about that. Come on. How would you like, I mean, God's, you worked all week. Maybe you was planning on buying them sandals you seen up in the store. And I said, sit down. I just feel to tell you, God's told me to tell you. Now, please don't go ahead and say something I didn't say. I said, to give me your paycheck for the week. I'll guarantee you I'll get a silence on the phone. I'm just trying to bring it into reality where you can feel it. Can you imagine what that woman felt for the second? But you've got to remember one thing. God had already talked to her. And God had done commanded her to take care of that man when he comes through those gates. How many has God ever told you to do something and you ask him, Lord, if this is really you, you do this. And Lord, if, amen, got that answer? Lord, if this is really you, you do this. And Lord, if that's really you, let them sing again. They've done sung it 49 times. Somebody shout amen. Are y'all preaching with me here tonight? Amen. But obedience does something that nothing else will do by the grace of an almighty God. Amen. Come on, somebody. I've never asked nobody to do that. But if God did that to you, amen, through the prophet or through the word of God, amen, God spoke to your heart and said, do this or that. Would you be willing to stick the rod out over a Red Sea? What can a stick do over a sea? What can a jawbone do against 1,000 warriors? Tell your neighbor, I don't think I've got much faith after all. It takes faith to obey God. Now, I can shout about, hey, man, I can shout with a golden calf. But shout when God says, give that last 20 you got. God, I really have plans for that 20. Don't let shout, hey, man. Hallelujah. See, God's good. Elijah said, I fear not. Go and do as thou hast said. But make me thereof a little cake first. You fix it and bring it to me. You know, we're pretty well obedient when God tells us to do something that don't cost us nothing. God, me putting this stick over his Red Sea, then people are going to think I'm crazy. I mean, they're already mad at me. And you want me to stick a stick over water? What's going to happen? When you're obedient to God, it opens the windows of heaven. See, you, amen, no matter what you're blessed with, amen, your blessing needs to come from God. You can have wealth and not be blessed. Amen. But make me thereof a little cake first and bring it unto me, and after make for thee and for thy son. Now listen, I don't think you understand me. Prophet Elijah, you didn't hear me. I've got a little handful of meal. I got a little oil. I'm going to bake this little cake for me and my son, and we're going to die. There's no seconds. What could God do through you if you will let him? I thought y'all shout with me on all this. What could God do at home, at your job? I wonder how many seats you could fill in this church if you let God use you. As you'd be as real there, come on now. And you know what that little woman did? She went in there, mixed that oil and that flour together, that meal together, baked that little cake, and she took that little cake that was in her hand, and she brought it back out there, and she said, here, man of God, you eat this. Somebody ought to shout yes. Amen. I get so sick and tired of somebody saying, well, they got more than I got. It ain't about, it's obedience. Somebody shout amen. Hallelujah. Amen. I was listening on the radio one Sunday morning to Brother Hurl Robertson, the same broadcast hour that I have now. Amen. He was on there. He had a missionary, amen, that went down into Mexico or somewhere. I can't remember exactly where it was at. And they were talking about, amen, that $20 would buy 50 pounds of rice. It would touch so many families. And I heard the voice of God say, go and give them $20. I drove over on Shawnee Drive, and I got out of that little car, that Pinto I was driving. One had a Cadillac, and one had another new vehicle. And the devil said, now you see them? They got more than you got. Get back in your car and go home. God didn't tell me to give $20 if they was riding in a road wagon. Some of y'all couldn't say amen. You got to loosen their jaws. We're stubborn. We say, God, I'll do this my way, not your way. Am I still preaching, y'all? We don't think some people need to. Let me tell you something. Go out and get a blessing off of a cursed tree. See what you get. Go out to an old rotten cursed tree and get good fruit off of it. You have to bless those that are blessed. I'm not taking a offering up tonight. Tomorrow night maybe, but not tonight. Somebody shout amen. Listen, God tells me. Somebody shout hallelujah. But I'm trying to tell you, I sat there in that car for just a minute. I'm driving a jalopy. I got holes in the floorboard. Amen. You can throw a good-sized dog through. And I'm going to give him, I need this more. But when I was listening to that radio, God said give him $20 to buy 50 pounds of rice. Well, he could sold that car and bought a whole bunch of rice. I love y'all, but I'd like to take somebody's blood pressure about right now. It's the truth. I walked in there, and I said, God told me, come over here and give you $20 to feed four families. I got back in my little Pinto. And I drove out of that driveway. I looked at their Cadillac, their new pickup truck. Somebody shout amen. It wasn't about what I seen, about what God told me to do. Somebody shout amen. Somebody shout amen. Am I preaching to y'all this night? Amen. People, listen. Amen. I don't understand why that we think that, amen, that we can control this thing. God says, amen, if you allow me, I'll take what you got. It looks like nothing and make something out of it. Can I get a witness in this house? God knows how to do things. Can I get a witness in here? How many knows that God knows how? Amen. Brother, I'm going to tell you something. I know what it was. Amen. Amen. At Rowena, I know what it was. Amen. And people make fun of me, but I said one day, God said, I'm going to send you somewhere else. And you know what God done? God said, I'll take care of that. You just keep on being faithful by the power of God. Somebody ought to shout yes. Amen. I know what it was like when this church didn't have no money. And after church, Sister Jean and I would go in them bathrooms and empty all the garbage into one garbage sack and wash the garbage sacks out right here. So we'd have money. Amen. See? Obedience brings victory. I walked in a church one time. God forgive me for saying this. Well, the people in that church was too sorry and too high and fluty to flush a toilet or clean one. And I was there in revival, And I clean toilets every day in another person's church because they stunk. Because church people was too. That's not my job. What if God. Excuse me. Woo! Come on, preach home, Brother Wayne. Glory to God. Hey, man. See, everybody wants the blessing. Everybody's wanting the Elijah anointing. Come on, somebody. Everybody wanted to preach under my tent. I said, go out there and wash your head in that cold water. Uh-uh. Go out there and sleep with the bugs. Uh-uh. Not big. I'm just trying to tell you, use what you got. I wanted a tent so bad, God spoke to my heart. I was preaching one Friday night at Rowena. Amen. In 1981, I believe it was. And I was preaching, and I sat back down on the altar, little altar bench, little bench. And I heard the voice of God say, get a tent. We wouldn't get enough money to pay the light bill. I got up that night and said, God spoke me to get a tent. And had a guy looked at me after church. He said, I need to talk to you just a second. I thought, well, praise God. He's going to give the first 100. He looked at me and said, listen, you don't need no tent. He didn't give the first penny on it either. He could have bought it. And not he could have just rested in his built overhauls and bought the tent and never got to his change purse. That's the truth. God said, get a tent. Amen. Sister Jean and I, we sold tater chips that was outdated. We sold carpet pieces. We went to Greensburg selling stuff. We went to Columbia selling stuff. We looked like the peddler of the year. Somebody shout amen. I don't think y'all understand. I didn't get here just on an easy street. And I heard on the trading post a tent for sale. I called that number and it was busy. I bound every devil in hell. Amen. That this call and get my tent. Somebody shout amen. I bound everybody, nobody buy my tent. Finally, I got a hold of that guy, and he said, I'm so-and-so, and I'm this. I said, I know you. I know where you live at. I said, I'll be there. I went down there. It was in his basement, a little yellow and white tent. He had it over in the corner, and some mice. He has some potatoes down there and stuff, and somehow mouse and chew some holes in that tent. And I asked him, I said, what did you do with this tent? He said, it don't have no poles with it, except the two center poles. He said, I use it at the fair. He said, I tied one end to a school bus. And he said, I run showgirls under it. I bound all them spirits. But most people wouldn't have had that thing. I bought that, and I took somebody back with me to get it. It was stretched out there in the yard, 30 feet, 20 feet, but 30 feet. Some called it a funeral tent. And that man looked at me, and he said, surely to God, you didn't buy that thing. I was 10,000 feet in the air. I found me a gospel tent that I could afford. We had worked and saved up $560, I believe it was. I took him $500. I've got the little savings book over there today where I took $500 out and give him $500. That guy said, surely to God you didn't buy that. He shot me down, but I fixed my engine and I got back up. And I brought that thing home. I don't know why I'm telling this. Somebody needs to say amen. Listen, if you're waiting for amen, it to come by your way easily, you ball and never get it. Amen. Can I preach a few minutes? I took that little 20, brought it home. Sister Jean and I went to Wilson's Building Supply. We bought two befores. We painted two befores. We painted them poles. And honey, here we went down the road, amen, with a cutoff pickup bed behind us. Amen. Poles sticking out of the little camper that we had. And we looked like a three-ring circus. That's what they called me. But I'd set that little thing up and I'd preach like the world was coming to an end before night. And people begin to get saved. People begin to get their lives changed. And 36 years later, God done a complete work in tents. Can I get a witness in this house? Some of y'all forgot, haven't you? Come on, somebody. I'm preaching good to you right now. I know you've got your story to tell. You can preach yours Wednesday night, Chris. I've got mine tonight. Somebody shout amen. We put that little tent up. I kept it 2 years. God showed me to buy another one. I bought a bigger one because that filled that one. It would only hold about 70 people. And that was full, packed out, standing around the corners. Somebody shout amen. And I sold it to a guy out of Ohio. I can't remember his name. But I thought I was nutty. Honey, that guy was serious about serving God. Somebody shout hallelujah. He took that little tin and amen. Hallelujah. God's good. Can I get a witness in here? I said, use what you got. If it's a cake, God says, give it to me. Amen. You'll be blessed. And I'll guarantee you, your meal barrel won't run dry. Your crews won't run out. And when everybody else is saying how they're doing it, you'll say, look what the Lord has done. Amen. The barrel never ran over. The barrel never was full. They went in there every morning and got them enough out to bake them a cake. They got enough out of a night to bake. Somebody ought to shout yes in here. I'm talking about the goodness of God. How many wants God to use you tonight? How many wants to use what God has already gave you? Amen. God gave me a tent. It wasn't that big preachers. It wasn't that big name preachers. But it was what God gave me. And I use it to the fullness. Oh, those people that made fun of it. Those people that wouldn't come because it wasn't. They didn't want to be seen in something like that. Hello? But that didn't change God from being real. When I bought that tent, God showed me where to set it the first time. I had a vision, didn't know where he's even at. Seen a vision of a man taking down a fence and mowing a lot of, and let me set that tent inside that fence. Man came to church and got saved. His name was Homer Smith. Lived out in the Webb's Crossroad community. He said, preacher, he said, you can set your tent on my lot. He said, I got a little lot out there in front of my trailer. He said, you can set it. I drove out there one day to look at it. He was out there in the front just like God showed me in that dream. Him taking down that fence. Amen. There was a little cow. He had some calves turning out. Amen. Turned it. Amen. He took her down that fence and let me set that tent just like God said. Somebody ought to shout yes in here. I'm talking about the goodness of an almighty God. Amen. Don't wait till the chariot comes by. Keep on a walking. You may have to walk down the dusty road, but there'll be a miracle on down the road. Can I get a witness in here? Amen. Give me just a couple minutes tonight. Give God another shout of praise. In 1 Samuel chapter 17, a little lad, a little boy, a little guy that nobody thought was much, that Samuel took a horn of oil and put on him and said, you're going to be the next king of Israel. He went down to check on him. He was despised of his brethren. Can I get a witness in here? But my God, amen, he went down there. Here's the challenge of a mighty Goliath. Amen. The Philistines champion. Amen. He went down to the brook. Somebody shout. He went down to the brook and he got him five smooth stones. What in the world is a stone? What's a BB going to do to a man that's might near 10 foot tall that weighs 450 some pounds? What is a BB going to do to him except make him mad? Armor from here to his knees. A sword bigger than David. But David puts in his sling a little smooth stone. And that stone leaves that little sling on the direction of the Holy Ghost. It hits old Goliath in a little place that ain't got no protection. Who would ever thought about that? Nobody but God. And God knew how to bring him down. He fell down and sounded like a junkyard crashing. Somebody ought to shout yes. And David didn't know how to kill him. There's no sword in his hand. He took Goliath's own sword and cut his head off. God, church, the potential you and I have. Oh, if I just somebody told me like a while back, says, "Boy, if I just change churches, I'd be so much happier." I said, "It's like changing socks; they'll get dirty there too." Everything has a honeymoon. Then you wake up one morning and realize you gotta go back to work. Love is good, but boy, you can't live off of it. He don't know. He don't pay bills. Are some of y'all from this world? Huh? It's the truth. Boy, Sister Gina, if we had honeymoon, but man, one day she said, "You gotta go work. We gotta have some groceries. Gotta eat." Somebody shout, amen. Woo! Five smooth stones. Huh? One of them. All it took is one. He had four brothers they took care of, too. Just don't hit him right there. God's able to use something that looks so insufficient, so insignificant, something that don't matter anything. Let me tell you, sometimes calling somebody, when you feel the lead to call them, say, "Hey, I've been praying for you," can make a life's difference in their life. Can I get a witness in here? Come on now. Amen. Sometimes just a text say, "Boy, that was good preaching, Brother Wayne. It helped me a whole lot. He got on me, but it sure did help me." Amen. Acts chapter number 3. I'm almost done. Tell your neighbor, use what you got. Amen. What do I have tonight that God can use? God used a rod in Moses' hand. Used a new jawbone for Samson. He used, a little bit, a handful of meal for Elijah and a widow woman. He used five smooth stones for David. Amen. The book of Acts chapter number 3. Amen. In verse number 2, I believe it is. Amen. Give God a shout of praise. Amen. Come on, give God a shout of praise. Certain man laid from his mother's womb. Amen. Hey, this man was, listen. I was praying for some people one night. Had some more people praying with me. Man came up and said, "I want to see." Said, "I can't see." I prayed my heart out. Forgot to let that man see. I had one of them guys that prayed with me. Walked with me after church. He said, "You sure that God didn't believe that he was going to see, did you?" That was his words. Why was you up here praying if you didn't believe that? Now, if I don't believe God can touch you, I ain't gonna pray for you. I'm wasting my time and yours both. God wants to use you. Brother Kenny Montgomery, God wants to use you. Amen. God knows how to take, Brother Austin, God knows how to use you. He knows how to take you. Even in your mess or your situation and still use you to His glory. Can I get a witness? He was there to ask alms. He was at a beautiful gate. He was asked alms of them in the temple. They laid him. This was a thing. It was habitual. It was every day they laid him there. Every day, daily at the gate of the temple asking alms. Next verse, please. Amen. Amen. Who seeing Peter and John about to go into the temple, ask an alms. Would you give me a little something? Something to help me just today. Help me to get through today. I'll be back tomorrow, but I need a little help today. And Peter fastened his eyes on him with John and said, look on us. Raise your hands and shout, amen, God's about to do something. And he gave heed unto them, expecting to receive something of them. He was expecting something, but what he was getting ready to get, he wasn't expecting. Somebody shout hallelujah. He was expecting a little silver or a little gold. And Peter said, I don't have any silver. I don't have any gold. Amen, have I none? But such. Tell your neighbor, you got it. You have it. Oh, God, if you ain't got it, we need to get it. I pray people, they didn't live. I pray people, they have lived. I got preacher friends that almost, because they believed God and things didn't happen the way they should have happened or the way they prayed. People got disgruntled with them, got upset with them, and left them. And them preachers, some of them backslid. Because they're willing to walk as long as they've got fish and loaves. As long as they're getting it their way, they love it. Somebody shout amen. Old black man one time, there's going up a hill in the wagon. An old mule just barely could get up that hill. He got out and began to push and asked some of his mothers to help him. They said, no, it's too much work. They finally got the wagon up to the top of the hill. They all started to jump in the wagon. He said, oh, no. You didn't have to push it up the hill. You ain't riding over the hill. Sometimes you got to do something out of the ordinary to get the extraordinary. Tell your neighbor, use what you got tonight. I wonder that devil has fought some of you. If you was to start giving things, amen, that you don't want to give, why have it break them old spirits off of you? Somebody shout amen. If I know you like chocolate cake, and I thought I wouldn't give you a piece of cake if you wanted it. You know what I'd do? I'd go if I couldn't bake you one, I'd have Sister Kathy back there to fix you one. Somebody shout amen. But you'd have a chocolate cake. Why? To whoop a devil. Somebody will shout amen in here. I'm preaching pretty good to you. Amen. I had a need almost done. Amen. I'm just telling you what God shows me. Had a need one time. It's $1,500. Lived down in that trailer. God spoke to me on a Sunday night while I was preaching at Rowena. Spoke to me and said, that guy's going to come to your house tomorrow. To meet your need. That man walked on me after church. He said, can I come to your house tomorrow? It's on the 30th of May. Monday day. We sat on the porch and we talked a few minutes. He said, let's walk around your place. He walked around, seen my snapper lawnmower, seen my building,
It's in a little toolbox in it. It's in a few tent things. And he looks at me and he says, you got more than I got. Gets in his truck, drives off, drives back to Campbellsville where he lived. Never seen that man since. A spirit got a hold of him because he seen something and he made a judgment, not on what God said, on what he thought. I'm preaching good to you. I don't know who I'm preaching to, but somebody here needs to break some demons and pull down some strongholds. Somebody shout hallelujah. When God says something, you need to do it. Tell your neighbor, but such as I have. Come on, tell your neighbor, such as I have. Amen. As they come back to the music, such as I have. I don't know who I'm preaching to tonight, but I'm telling, yes, I do know I'm preaching to you. Tell your neighbor, he's preaching to me right now. Amen. Such as I have. Raise your hands and shout, I have tonight. Amen. And listen to me. Amen. As I close with this, there was a little boy that brought two little sardine type fish. Amen. To a crowd of 5,000 men plus women and children. Amen. And Philip said, amen, send the multitude away. Amen. It's going to be night. They'll faint in the way. Amen. Send them home. Amen. But Jesus said, is there anything here to eat? And finally they found one little boy that had two fish and five little pieces of bread. And Philip said, what's this among so many? This won't even fill my hollow tooth. My brother-in-law there, raise your hand. This one right there. He can eat more than five men. He's got a hollow leg. Talks about me eating. Somebody shout amen. He's a dandy. Both of them are. But God's good. Somebody shout amen. Jesus said, bring me the fish. He said, set them down in 50s. Set them down. Two fish. Honey, they could have been a mile long. Not been enough fish. But in the hands of God, what you're willing to give God can change everything in your life. I've been willing to give God myself. Ain't always been easy. Ain't always been easy. It seemed like some's had it a whole lot easier than I have. Some had a little harder than I have. Amen. Never will forget my beloved brother. Can I, Brother Tom Brock. I was in Lebanon, Kentucky in a tent revival. Offerings were just nothing. Dollar and a half, $5, change. We were in a hard place. I asked somebody, I said, would somebody just give tonight? Somebody could probably give $100. Brother Tom Brock made $125 a week milking cows at that time. He walked up and gave me a check for $125. I didn't know it till the service was over. And I went in that camper. I fell on my knees and I cried like a baby. I said, God, I don't want this. God said, I want to bless that man. And I cried to God. I said, God, never let me do anything to hurt you or hurt people or bring a reproach. Because the people are willing to give sacrificially. I should be willing to walk sacrificially. And I prayed over that. It wasn't long after that that God blessed him with some things he didn't have. And it came, I know exactly where it came from.
Somebody shared. Many of y'all done that, but I just shared that one story. God's a good God tonight. He's a mighty good God. Are you willing to use what you have tonight? Stand to your feet. Are you willing to give what you've got tonight by the power of God? How many like to break some devils? How many like to break against the powers of hell? Come on, somebody. Are you willing, amen, to go the extra mile for just a moment? Amen. Are you willing to say, God, not my will, but thine? Use what you have tonight. You can pray until God. Man, one time was praying for, he said, God, if you'll make me a millionaire, I'll support the gospel. He came to him and he said, I've been praying for God to make me a millionaire and I'll support the gospel. I said, do you pay your tithes now? Oh, no, no, no. He said, I don't pay my tithes. He said, I don't give that. I said, you telling me that you'll give on $1 million when you won't give on 75? You won't. I don't care what you say. I don't care what you say. Because the word of God backs that up. If you're not faithful a little, you ain't faithful much. Somebody shout amen. If you won't give me a bite of your hamburger, you sure to God ain't gonna give me a half of it. Told Canyon one day, I said, can't give me a bite of that. He said, no, you take too big a bite. Thanks a lot, Canyon. So part of the night and I felt something touch me on the back. He said, where's your water? I seen a little sneaky grin on his face. He drunk my water. Won't know where my water was at. That's all right. Somebody shout amen. Didn't you? Yeah. But tonight God's good. How much willing to give? Say, God, here am I tonight. Come on. God, here am I. This altar's open if you're lost tonight. Give yourself to God. There'll be a change in your life. Now I can preach a lot of this different way. Amen. This, I have no intentions of preaching this message like this. Tell you these stories, but they bear record. Somebody shout amen. Know what it is to have church with no carpet on the floors. Know what it is not to have no money, but I know what it is to have the blessing of the Lord upon me. Somebody shout amen. Would you right now just raise your hands and say, God, here am I, if you really mean that. Say, God, use me. God, you put something in my hand, a jawbone, a rod, a fish. God, there's something that you put in my life that I can bless somebody with tonight by the power of God in the name of Jesus. Come on, raise your hands and just love him. There's somebody tonight, if you really want a move of God, you got to give something, folks. Come on, reach out and touch him right now. Come on, would you lift your voices to him and begin to pray, God, stir my heart tonight. Stir my spirit tonight. God, minister to my knees tonight. In the name of Jesus. Come on, reach out to him. I know what it is to be in need, and I know what it is to have plenty. I know what it is for being Sister Jean to have to pray, God, you got to move. I know what it is to back out of my driveway and my light bill be due and no money. I pull back in and it's paid for. That's the goodness of God, church. Come on, would you love him right now? Come on, would you love him right now? Sing it.
All fear is gone.
This altar's open if you're lost tonight.
Because I know
somebody may need to surrender something to God. This altar's open tonight by the power of God. Come on, love him. Come on and love him tonight by the power of God.
And life is worth the living
just because he lives. Anybody want to pray tonight?
And because he lives, I can face tomorrow.
Father, by the power of God, for my brother's body, God. God, the stress that he's been under. God, the load he's been carrying. But tonight, God, he's going to leave it all here. God, at the foot of the cross, by the power of the Holy Ghost. In the name of Jesus, brother. God's making a way. He's making a way for you. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Sun's coming up. Her need tonight, Lord. God, right now, with the power of God. Come on, worship God right now, church. Hallelujah. Come on, love Him tonight. Tonight, hallelujah.
Because He lives.
Oh, yes, God, hallelujah.
And all fear is gone.
God, reach your hands this way.
Because I know He holds the future.
Thank you for it, Lord. In the name of Jesus.
And life is worth the living.
He's a mighty good God tonight. Hallelujah. I want you to raise your hands one more time over this place and say, God, I want to give it in your hands. How many really does? God, I want to put it in your hands. Hallelujah. Brother Brian, I see a breakthrough for you, brother. By the power of the Holy Ghost, I want you to raise both hands. I feel a breakthrough right there for you in the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Just lay your hands on Him right there. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. In the name of the Lord. Come on, somebody praise Him. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Give me the key of G. Hallelujah. I said, if God be for us, who can be against us? And who can separate us from God's mighty hand?
If God be for us, who can be against us?
In the name of Jesus, God, make a way for them. Father, the power of the Holy Ghost. God, in the name of Jesus, God, I've delivered my soul. God, I appreciate God what You've given me. Now for them tonight, God, make that way. God, provide in the name of Jesus. God, with Your word and Your power, and by the Spirit of the Almighty God, touch them tonight. In the name of Jesus. Lions were roaring, fierce and hungry, but Daniel knew the one he said was gonna bring him out. The king cried, oh, Daniel had joy. God delivered you. He replied, my God has shut those lions out. Father, for me is right now, in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, make that way. Make that way.
Who can be against us? We're going to win the battle.
In the name of Jesus.
God,
in the name of Jesus.
The giant stood there boldly.
Come on, put your hand together.
Defying God's army. But there stood little David, but he did not stand alone. He said, in the name of the Lord, I come against you. Why, he slew that giant with a sling and a stone. If God be for us, who can be against us? And who can separate us?
For us, and who can be against us? We're gonna win.
God we stand.
If God be for us, who can be against us?
And who can separate us from God's mighty hand? If God be for us, who can be against us? We're going to win the battle if for God we stand.
Well, let's give the Lord a shout of praise tonight. Come on, give God a shout of praise. Come on, let's give God a praise. Come on, let's give God praise.